be more relevant relative to Leech Kiro.
Link Dagger, Yule Scepter, Macroplier first, into the Dual Breath, in with the Ice Path. There will be a multicast coming up from Arcade, but at the same time, Arteezy does another setup. The Ice Path back off cooldown now, and Arcade cannot run himself away. Even Arteezy going for the extra silence. Zai comes in to kill Secure with that last little attack at Lightning Brock. And they're looking to go high ground. Arteezy has Exorcism and Aegis of the Immortal. He wants to get the Yule Scepter up against, they could just go for a secondary Ice Path, but they rotate to bottom lane. That's where the damage came into the tier 3 tower. The fortification will slow it down, but with Liquid Fire, the second this fortification comes off, the towers are gone. The bottom ranks as well being focused. They're going for the melee to start with. They realize they have enough damage to do this.
They can't initiate with Universe in this position, because if they blink on him, he'll just blink in Yules, and he'll counter-initiate the Batrider so easily, and then Abaddon can just shield whatever Brewmaster has to throw at him like this, or they take too long to push, because...
But you can't go in for Roshan, because the next prop can just sit up on top lane and
keep
forcing it out.
Well, they had a small window while those two heroes were down, but, I mean, the stars have not aligned.
They're coming again. They've got Arteezy actually having the Disco effect on him, and then Abra Bulldog actually picks him up and drags him back in again. But there will be shield protection. Arteezy, he is going to go down. They got the mana void on, but the Ice Path Macropyre is burning through their life points. Abra Bulldog, he's almost ticking out. There will be an Ice Ultimate out from Misery and loaded with a triple kill as his animate. The Ice Path fall from Universe, but Harney right from their tail. They're looking for more stuns. Zai's going to buy back into this. They want Harney down. The familiar birds are still here. Harney will drop. Loader, he's worth so much money right now. There's 7 kills over on him. He'll blink away to safety. The buyback coming out from the Crystal Maiden. They're just trying to hold on to their rack right now. The bottom lane's already forced its way in. The familiars are beating down the melee racks. There is a Yule Scepter over an Abra Bulldog with the Dual Breath. They're looking for some more stuns, but it's the familiar burst that do bring down the melee racks. Already EG just back up. They're not under pressure. Abra Bulldog finds one, but PPD just shields him and the Yule Scepter up. Follow-up Ice Path. Loader has to BKB, but Arteezy, he's got the ulti in here. They will pop the Brewmaster ultimate, but Fear, he's going down so quickly. That cleave damage with the mana void, it's not enough to get the kill. Loader's blinking himself away. There's just too much physical DPS. They go through the entire Brewlings. And what do they really get from that? They lost more. Abra Bulldog picked up Yule Scepter, four-stopping him out, but the Ice Path hold is still there, and they even get the attack in with the silence, following just one after the other. It's a turkey shoot right now. RK will be the next one. It's a double kill for Arteezy. Either way, EG have almost every ulti off cooldown. The Wrath of Nature is only just triggered. So it pushes all the other lanes in. That mid tower's at 14 life points, 9 up by the Ogre Machine. The Brewmaster will be sent up, the Ice Path will connect as well. Harney, no ulti, 3 seconds on cooldown. But there's your jump out by Abra Bulldog. He found Zai, and Universe, well, PPD couldn't get there in time to save him. Zai will go down. The ult just popped from Arteezy with the BKB to protect him. But the Kree Wave soaking up a lot of this. Then you also got Fear stepping towards the end. Loader is waiting for him to hit the deck. He's waiting forever for this hero to hit the ground. Now he finally does. Misery in as well. Fear being broken free by PPD, but it's not enough stability for him. They're gonna lose out on these heroes. The familiars are actually bringing down the fortress while all this is going on. It's a triple kill for Loader. They're gonna move into PPD as well. They have to look back to their base, however. The double TPs are coming in. The familiars are rather problematic for Alliance. But all tier 4 towers down, which is what's making that fortress exposed.
This is actually really, really bad for EG. All of a sudden, they're going to have their T3s pressured. And even if they buy back, they're not going to have Exorcism.
Mm-hmm.
This could potentially be close to game, although CM can't do anything versus the...
They've actually only got buybacks on Deathprop and Chikiro. And now Deathprop has used hers. The top lane is still pushing in again. The familiars are coming in for round 2. The fortification is slowing down the tier 3 towers.
Arteezy can't come close. If he gets multicasted, it's very close to game.
Yep.
And luckily for EG, Roshan is not that close to respawning.
He's getting in really close though. Chikiro is not back up just yet. Loader, low on life. All he gets is the ranged racks, however, but he knew what he could get. But this fortress, again, is under attack. The familiars come forward. And Misery, as well as the familiars, they just keep attacking directly into the fortress. So they don't even care about heroes. They're going to lose one of these familiars, however. Potentially too, a Nova reveal. Abra Bulldog uses the Firefly. He's got them both. They have to resummon. There's no choice here from Fear to lose that kind of... Look at the experience graph, man.
I mean, they didn't really execute poorly at all last fight.
Look at them wait. Look at them wait. Misery's going to come forward. He never even knew it was coming, but now Abra Bulldog, the Ice Path will go down. Loader got caught inside of it. He's already down to a third of his life points. The split will come up from Harney. The Crystal Maiden died very, very quickly, and they just keep trying to battle this one up. They need more. Where is he going? He's going all the way inside the base. The Ice Path won't save him. Again, they'll connect over on Loader. Where is your Bivest coming? Zion wants to send his ground. The Familiars, they're all dead again. And Loda, he's slowed down a long way. PB is still on the front lines. They're throwing out the Soul Assumption damage into RK, but he's got so many low people life. Maybe Loda, that's not enough damage to the Mana Void, but Universe forced up the way. 39 life points, turns for one last Ice Bar, then forced up back down again. Find the Monte Cards, will kill him off, but they got the big one. They managed to bring down Loda. Hani clapping, brawling. It's not enough. They've lost too many heroes. The Batrider is defending the fortress at the moment. The Brewmaster had to buy back. And EG though, are they out of fuel? Can they even push high ground against this? There is fortification available for Alliance. If this goes down, he can actually solo up the fortress.
Yeah, it's nice that they have a secondary source.
Oh, Bulldog jumps in. They got PBD low again. Hani, he doesn't have ulti. He's 8 seconds. Admiral Bulldog! Oh, that's big! That's big! He's down. He buys back straight away. Loda's coming out to fight. He also bought back here. So a double buyback by Alliance. Nothing is left for their buybacks right now. The smoke's going to break right now, but they don't want PPD. He's the one target they don't want. Fee, however, they'll take him any day. Drag him back down, and now Loda, he's in, but you're right. Zai, he's actually having a crack. There is still fortification. Hani comes out here to try and stop him. They're trying to TP back, and that's what Arteezy is cancelling. He's holding Loda outside the base. Four star up. They get him up the cliffside. That means away from the Ultimate Arcade. He's in a little bit too far right now, and he will go down. Hani jumping out. He's still got split bubble. Does not want to use it. But the throne still stays alive for the moment.
Hani was onto that immediately.
Yep. He was there before anybody else. Now he jumps in. Goes for the split. Arteezy, the man on the front lines. He BKBs. So have to control Universe instead, but PPD's got the shield over on him. That Fire Brilling staying on the front lines. They need to get closer. The Node from Misery all out, but look at the Familiars. They're tearing apart across the Maiden. Zai TP's in to finish the job. Now the LOA snuffing towards the end. Loda, still half on life points. And Admiral Bulldog, he gets a lasso over on Zai. The Nature's Prophet's gonna go down. The buyback instantly coming out from him. Hani, so low. The Crypt Swarm from Arteezy got to finish him off. Universe needs an opening target, and he can't get it. Loda blinks himself up to safety. Admiral Bulldog backing up. Zai is actually taking out the range racks. Now focusing the melee while the rest of Elias, they have to get back here. Universe on light, the Mana Void. Loda will pick up a double kill, but he's set up in towards the air. The BKB back up. The melee racks is still not down yet. They're mopping up the trees for the moment. Arteezy still the front lines. We got more for support coming in. Maybe RK. Where's your multicast? No joy of misery. Letting the ulti rip. They got Arteezy. Triple kill for Loda. He's still up and running. Moves to Zai. Dropping him down. They need to keep this battle going. Loda, Monicast, make him bigger. PPD, he'll drop. No, he won't. Loda's to finish the job. They're back to the melee racks. They've got to get rid of these Familiars. Two down, one to go. But EG, they're forcing themselves back. Bulldog still wants this pickoff. He won't find the opening. Even then, they can actually turn onto him. The Blink Dagger is available. He'll blink himself away. The Sprout, forced up, goes up on top of the cliffside, but he's gonna walk there. The Flame Break, Admiral Bulldog, he's down for the count. Support's coming in from Loda. There's just so many heroes low. He wants to fight this one, but he's silenced up. Nanasar will break free. There's no Mana Void available for him, so he can't get the kill straight away. Loda will be forced back for the moment. While the Familiars, they finish the melee racks in the middle lane. It was only one of them with a catapult, but it does the job. The Battle of the Rack continues. EG, they bring down all Rax's Das Megas.
Eventually, they're going to break, and it's kind of ironic that this is happening to
Loda! It's Rapier time! It is Rapier time in Animage. He sells the Vladimir's offering. The problem is he can't take this unless he wants to drop a BKB. Maybe that's still worth it. Maybe that's worth it. It's only 5 seconds in duration.
He could drop the Power Treads since he has Bloodlust.
True. Familiar is coming in. It's gonna scout it out. Loda getting bashed up by Roshan. He gets through the Familiar. What's he gonna drop? Misery comes in. Forced up in by PPD. What do they pick up here? Crystal Maiden takes the Aegis, the Immortal. Roshan still killed by the Dire Prophet. Died so quickly. And the Brewmaster ulti, they'll allow them to follow into PPD. There's enough with the clap, the stun. Meanwhile, back at base, Universe trying to force up. He's gonna kill off Misery. Liquid going into the fortress, Misery, he had the cheese and the Aegis the Immortal. Universe, four times in the multicast, he still picks up one. Misery drops the ultimate down, the liquid fire is ticking. Arteezy, him with the ultimate, they finish this job. Arteezy, he's a chicken out of the matter, but kills him off. Besides, the only one up, 200, maybe there's enough, 140, 136, it's not enough yet, they're still holding the line. Aegis the Immortal comes up, they've got to keep the ready green wave on. 55 life points, the Rapier is on the ground. Loder ended up dying. They need to save him. Misery is dying. They cannot allow the Familiars. They're coming in to Evil Genius will take it. Disappointing. deployment from Alliance. They held as long as they possibly could. But up against Megas, they held the line as far as they could. But it was not enough.
That's one of those games where had Alliance played like slightly better in the first 20 minutes or delayed a Rax push by like 2 minutes, the game would have ended differently. But I mean, evil geniuses. I thought they were done for with Jakiro.
I thought so too. They were throwing everything they had at that fortress. And they bypassed the Rax so many times, like, well, I'm not doing this Megas. We're going directly for GG. Like, that was the goal right there. And they almost lost the entire thing. They got smiles on their faces. You saw actually the expression from Loda at the end of that one. Like, it looked like disappointment directly on his face.